winter dressings for you.
Oh, good, good. All right. I didn't want to wake you, so. All right. It's nice to see you. I brought you something special because you were mentioning that it was cold in here. Yeah, so I brought a really warm blanket here, and it's very special because there's a hair. Sorry. It's very special because it's handmade, so it's going to keep you warm, alright? Alright, I'm going to set this right here for you. Okay. Alrighty. So, are you ready for a checkup? I'm going to check your temperature, breathing, all that. And then we're going to look at your wound and then redress it. How does that sound? Good. All right. So, the doctor is a little bit worried about possible infection due to the area. Stomach wounds tend to have a higher rate of infection just due to the type of surgery that you had. So I do want to change your drip, okay? I'm gonna change that pick for you. But let's get started with temperature, okay? All right, so I'm just gonna wipe this off. It's really painful. I can give you something for the pain. I do have an order for Toradol if you need it, but I'd rather not. But again, just let me know what your pain tolerance is, how you're feeling. I don't want you to be uncomfy. Okay. You aren't feeling anything else? How about any dizziness or nausea? Fever, you think? No, okay. Oh, okay, it's ready. Just gonna grab this real quick, okay? There we go. Okay, good, good. Looking good. Temperature. And while I'm here, I'm just gonna listen to your heartbeat, okay? Stand very still. Okay. Okay, got a strong heartbeat. Very good. Very good. All right, so, like I said, I'm gonna start out by giving you some Keflex. I think we're gonna put some antibiotics in your drip. Okay, just wanna make a note for the doctor that your temperature and your heart is good, your lungs are good. Okay, so I'm just gonna get up and I'm going to mess with your pick a little bit, all right? Let me know if anything's uncomfortable and I will stop right away. All right. Okay. Crowd back here. Okay. So I'm just going to remove the bandage where your port is, okay? Okay, you're not in pain. Awesome. Next, I need to disinfect your port before I change it. Area around it as well. There we go. Okay, and here we go. I'm gonna change it. That's where you lie. Okay, I'm just gonna re-stick it on there. Those antibiotics should last you. Okay. How we feeling? Good, good. I'm just gonna make a note that I gave you a new pick this time. Alrighty, so, okay, I just want to check your lymph nodes, okay, make sure everything's fine before I move on to changing or dressing, okay, alright. Everything been going good with you otherwise? Any fun new TV shows you're watching? I have not watched that one yet, but I saw a lot of people were really interested in it, so would you recommend it? Yeah? Okay, I'll have to check that one out then. Alright, so I'm just going to... feel your face here. Make sure that this area around here isn't swollen. And I'm going to check underneath, okay? Check underneath your chin. Check your lymph nodes here. Good. On the side here, and then I'm going to check, okay? Right up here near your ear. Alright, alrighty, alright. Those seem just fine. And I'm gonna feel down your sure those lymph nodes are good. Nothing swollen. Thyroid is okay too. Okay, good. Alright, I'm actually going to also check your axillary lymph nodes. They're around your armpits. So if you're able to, can you lift your arms up for me? Okay. Thank you so much. Okay. Good. And over here. Okay. Very good.
And the doctor also knew
The doctor noted that she wanted me to check the lymph nodes on your chest as well. So I'm just going to feel up here. Since there's a proximity to your stomach where your wound is. Alright, we're good. We're good. Oh, shall we move on to the dressing? Now, you did say that it was feeling sore. A little bit of a dull pain there. So I'm going to be very gentle. Okay. First, I need to... I'm just going to get this set up. Set that there. I need to grab scissors so I can take this one off. There you are. Okay. And this part right here, so it comes off really easy. Alright. How are we feeling? Okay. I'm going to gently remove this, okay? So now I have a better look at how it's healing. Okay, so I do see some redness, but let's clean it up. Is that just the right enough pressure for you? I don't want to be too harsh. I do want to make sure I scrub well. Okay. here. Gotta get these sides. Okay, very good, very good. The excess of my gloves here. Hair is getting in the way, huh? Using gauze to wipe it off, and there's definitely some floaties in the air, huh? Nice and dry. Okay, very good. All right, get these floaties out of here. Okay, so I'm just gonna take a quick look here. I'm gonna examine your wound. Okay, so I do see a couple other colors of the rainbow here, but that is to be expected. Okay, stitches are looking good. Those should dissolve soon. Those ones won't. I'll have to let the doctor know that there doesn't seem to be any signs of infection. Looking real good. Redness, though, there is a good amount of it. Maybe it's just the way your body handles surgery, but I do think I'll need to measure the amount of redness just in case. Make sure that it's going down next time I see you. Okay. Next, I'm going to check where it hurts and how far it extends. Alright, so I'm just going to gently put pressure right here. How does that feel? Okay, what about right here? And here? Okay, what about right here? Okay, and all the way out here. And other side. Okay, what about down here? Okay, and up here. Good. Now, as I get closer, does this part right here, is that hurt more or less than the surrounding areas? Okay, what about right here? Okay, what about this pen here, and I'm going to draw around the redness, and when I come in next to rewash a wound, I'm just going to, this is visual for me to see how much the redness has gone down or gone up. Okay, so hold still, I'm just going to draw. draw around the redness here. I know it's kind of silly, okay, but it's in a wash. Make a note of the painful areas, how far the pain extended, I measured. I didn't write down. I just need one, two. Okay. The doctor will want to see your progress as well, so it's good to write things down. Something just antibacterial as well. But now I'm just going to. Okay, so I'm going to put this around the area. Thank you. so the pain even extended around over here. Okay. Excellent. Okay, good. And I'm just going to put some This is just for to reduce the rate of infection if it just swells. So I'm just going to gently put this close to the wound area. Should promote healing as well. Okay. Just one last, but just going to pat it in. Now, let's cover this back up, shall we? Alrighty. Gonna lift your shirt up a little bit more, okay? To reveal your stomach a bit, because this is going to be on the surrounding areas as well. To make sure that it is placed perfectly, placed perfectly, placed perfectly. There we go. And let's wrap you up here. Make sure that you have breath in your lungs so that I don't accidentally make this too tight. Okay, and back around. And just one more time, okay? One more time. Okay, let's get over here. And right. Right there. Okay, and everything is good here. Nothing's gonna fall off. Okay, doesn't feel tight. Take a deep breath for me. Does that feel restrictive at all? I mean, it shouldn't since it's around your stomach, but just in case, sometimes we breathe into our stomachs and not into our diaphragm. I know that doesn't make sense, but if you're a singer, it will, or it would. Which I am not, I just happen to know. Okay, so everything looks good. Alright, is the gel already working? Okay, so you don't think you're gonna need any extra pain? Anything extra for the pain? Okay, that is good to hear. Okay. Wonderful. Okay. How is your medication doing? You've been taking it? Okay, good. Have you missed any days? It's okay, you can tell me. Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna take a look at it, okay? Seems to be in there. Alright, so we didn't miss any days. What about nights? Because I know some we only take during the day and some we take at night. Okay. Alright. Good. Okay, so that one you can't take during the day as well. I mean, you could, but it's going to cause drowsiness, so I don't recommend that, which is why we had that scheduled for nighttime. So if you could, I know, hair on my lip again. I know it can be such a pain to take medication, but try not to patch it up, okay? What about the one that you take once a week? Mm-hmm. Did you feel any nausea from that? Okay, so it upset your tummy? Tell me, did you eat a meal with it? Okay, so that's not gonna be enough. So for that one, you're going to need to eat a full breakfast, or else it's really gonna upset your tummy. Yeah. Just a bowl of oatmeal, unfortunately, isn't really gonna do it. Although oatmeal is really good for you, so I think great job with the oatmeal, but maybe add like some fruit or a banana, maybe a yogurt in there as well. And if you wanted to, maybe if someone was there to help you out and cook for you, maybe some eggs. Mm-hmm. Just a little bit more filling for that one. And then you shouldn't have issues with your upset stomach anymore. Okay. Do you need any refills? Send to the doctor. Okay, you're getting low on that one. And if you still have issues with an upset stomach on that one, and you do eat a full breakfast, I'll talk to the doctor and see if we can get a different one, maybe one that's less harsh on your tummy. Okay. So I'm just gonna make a note on that. Possible. Do you have any more questions for the doctor? Okay.
All right. I'm just gonna put a note of that. And I have to ask, especially with after surgeries like this, and we aren't allowed to, you know, be up and about as much, how are we doing on mental health, anxiety? Okay, on a scale of 1 to 5, how would you say your anxiety is? Okay. And is that regarding your recovery? Is it anxiety around your recovery? Or what is it a little? Oh, okay. Around getting back into it after. Yeah. Completely understandable. Any other mental health things that we should note? Yeah. I understand. Okay. So I'm just gonna let the doctor know. Okay. And she should be able to take a look at everything, see if any medications need to be changed out, and during the healing process, we could continue to monitor your anxiety and your other mental health issues that have popped up. I wouldn't be too worried. I think that they're just tied to your recovery here. A lot of feelings can pop up from something like this. Yeah. Okay. All right. So, one thing that I really need for you to do is to get some rest. Rest. All right? Yes. So that's how you're going to really expedite the healing process, is to get some really good sleep. 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 Nice.